Morning students, in this video we shall learn about a new chapter, new topic, capillarity. So please be patient and carefully watch this video. Capillarity. The phenomenon by virtue of which the level of liquid in a capillary tube is different from that of outside is called the capillarity. When a tube having a fine bore means a hole, but it is length, lengthwise hole. The hole was a lomba, that is called your fine bore, like bore well, is dipped in a liquid, the level of liquid inside the tube is different from that of outside. As a result, the liquid having acute angle of contact get rise into it, while those having obtuse angle of contact gets depressed or down into it. Rise of liquid in a capillary tube. So this is a capillary tube. As you can see, this is a capillary tube. It is dipped in a water. Here we have a molecule. This is O. This is a molecule, and this molecule will have a force of surface tension outward, and due to this it become like this. This upper surface become concave upward. So this T, force of surface tension, can be resolved into two components: upward your T cos theta, horizontal T sin theta. And due to this T cos theta, this level is something concave, and this resultant force is acting downward. This is your angle of contact theta, and this height is your edge height. This is your edge height, and this is your ABC. BC is the radius R, and total height is your this is a capillary tube of radius R. So by magnifying you look at this ABCD. This is your H plus R. AD is your R, DE is your H, and total height is your H plus R. So liquid we have in the cylinder, but not here. This is gap, a hemisphere. So the total volume will be volume of the cylinder CDEF, and this water below this meniscus. So that can be achieved by a difference between the cylinder ABCD. ABCD is a cylinder, and if you minus subtract this hemisphere volume, then we will get this liquid. So now consider a glass capillary tube of radius smaller, which is dipped in water. Water rises into the tube to a height h and has a meniscus concave upward. Water keeps on rising off into the tube till the total upward force due to surface tension is equal to the total downward force due to weight of water inside the tube. So let us find out the total upward force. Total force in the upward direction is nothing but T cos theta into circumference, which is your T cos theta into 2 pi r, or 2 pi r T cos theta. That is the equation 1. Now, weight of the liquid, we will want to find out. Let us find out the weight. So, W equal to mg, we know. Or W equal to V rho g, where V is volume of liquid, rho is your density, and g is your acceleration due to gravity. V equal to, we can find out volume of water in the cylinder CDEF plus volume of water below the meniscus and above CD. So volume of the cylinder will become pi r square h, and volume of water below the meniscus and above CD can be achieved or can be obtained by volume of cylinder ABCD minus volume of hemisphere of radius r. So V equal to pi r square h plus pi r, volume of ABCD cylinder is pi r square r minus volume of hemisphere is half into 4 by 3 pi r cube. So this is your pi r square h, pi r cube minus 2 by 3 pi r cube. So 2 by 3 pi r cube minus 2 by 3 pi r cube, it will be 1 by 3 pi r cube. So by taking common pi r square, it becomes h plus 1 by 3 r. So W equal to pi r square into h plus 1 by 3 r rho g. Where W equal to V rho g. This is your V and this is your rho g. Now for equilibrium, from equation 1 and 2, 2 pi r into t cos theta equal to this equation 2, pi r square into h plus 1 by 3 rho g. So by simplifying, we will get t equal to r into h plus r by 3 rho g by 2 cos theta. In case of fine cumulative, this r by 3, r is very very small, so r by 3 is obviously very very small, so it can be neglected. So t equal to r h rho g divided by 2 cos theta, or h equal to 2 t cos theta by r rho g. This is the height of the capillary rise. Since t, which is a surface tension, rho, density, g, acceleration and theta are constant, so h, so h proportional to 1 by r. Conclusion: hence rise of liquid rises or depressed in a capillary tube varies inversely as the radius of the tube. Tube of insufficient length. It can be proved that the liquid will never overflow and the liquid adjusts its curvature in such a way that the equilibrium is obtained with the available length of the tube. If you cut this capillary tube, the liquid will not overflow. It adjusts its radius. In this case, the meniscus will not be hemispherical. It is less than hemispherical. R is the radius of capillary tube. Capillary R is the radius of curvature of the meniscus. Here in the triangle, this your AOC triangle, you can get OA by AC equal to cos theta. So R by R equal to cos theta. That implies small r equal to R cos theta. So since h equal to 2t cos theta by r rho g, so we can put in place of small r, r cos theta. So cos theta will get cancelled. So h equal to 2t by r rho g, or r h equal to 2t by rho g. So t surface tension, rho density, g acceleration due to gravity, then are all constant. So r h equal to constant. So conclusion can be drawn: if the value of h will be smaller, r will be greater and the liquid will never flow. That means if you cut the capillary height, the liquid will never overflow. It will adjust itself. Thank you everyone. Thank you for your patience and watching this video.